when I came out to my team, I had some confidence. I could show people that I am fit to serve. I can be successful. Not only can I be successful, I can be better than I was before when I was pretending to be something I wasn't.
It's been over a year since we first met Staff Sergeant Jessica Hout, when she became one of the first soldiers to test out the U.S. military's new policy that trans troops can serve openly.
How did it go?
Went actually great. Sort of like, hey, you know, I've been kind of figuring stuff out for myself over the past few months, and went right to it and was like, hey, I'm transgender and I am going to transition.
The military's previous policy towards trans people was pretty much, if you come out, you can get kicked out. It was also quite literally built around things tweeted by former President Trump.
Company.
Team.
Attention.
The Department of Defense is estimated to be one of the country's biggest employers of trans people, so allowing trans soldiers to serve openly was a dramatic step forward. But 1 year after the policy was laid out, the experiences of people within the military have been much more complicated.
Did you get any negative reactions?
I feel like there was a lot of men that I work with who were just kind of like uncomfortable at first. That was kind of the general air.
You could feel that?
I could feel like they just kind of like looked down like.
Do you think the military is doing enough for trans soldiers?
No. Outside of the military, we are doing everything we can to try and get rid of all the barriers and gatekeeping that has occurred in trans health. And I feel like in the military, we still have those same barriers, requiring a brigade commander to approve my medical treatment plan, requiring a medical treatment plan that has to, you know, in reality, that's quite a violation of some medical privacy.
Every aspect of a soldier's transition has to be approved by the chain of command, from hair length to hormone therapy. A soldier can change their gender marker in the military's database, which is known as DEERS, but only once the military has deemed the soldier as, quote, stable in that gender. Sergeant Hout hasn't met that criteria, so she had to apply for an exception that would allow her to be treated as a woman. She applied for that over a year ago, and by the time we filmed this story, it still hadn't been approved.
My pronouns even have to be in line with my DEERS marker. So everyone at work should be referring to me as he and him.
But what do they use for you?
They use she and her. Since my marker is so incorrectly marked as male, I'm still expected to follow male grooming standards, male height and weight standards, male physical fitness standards.
So you've just been technically breaking the rules by growing out your hair.
It would have been too much of a mental toll for myself over this past year, waiting on a piece of paper saying that I could grow out my hair.
Could you have gotten into trouble at any point over the last year for growing out your hair without that piece of paper saying you can grow out your hair?
I could have.
Why didn't you?
I feel it just came down to support. And I felt supported from my chain of command since I've came out.
The experience of a soldier who comes out depends in large part on who they work with, specifically their commanders. Some trans soldiers call this command roulette. We requested an interview with Hout's leadership back when we first met her. A year later, we finally got approval.
Have you had to deal with any disparaging comments from anyone since Sergeant Hout came out?
No, the support from the company for Sergeant Hout has been entirely positive.
So essentially, you get to decide the timing of when a soldier under your command transitions.
I wouldn't say I get to decide the timing. Now, what I might be able to control is, hey, if we have a big training event coming up, I could ask you, like, hey, is it all right if we push this either to the left or to the right in order to facilitate this training event?
Have you been kind of just, you know, looking the other way or being more lax with the rules in order to allow her to present in a way that she wants to present?
I wouldn't say that we look the other way. I would say that each of our soldiers have extremely unique circumstances for what's going on in their lives. And for Sergeant Hout, that's definitely an area for her hair and grooming standards that we established was like, we can go ahead and assume the risk and allow her to grow out her hair now.
What about the commanders who aren't as accepting as you?
If there was a commander that was making decisions like that, I would believe that they would have other leaders around them that would give them that common sense check.
Do you think that military culture at large is open and accepting of trans service members?
Yes, I do.
Another reason why Hout's experience has been relatively positive might have to do with her rank. We interviewed at least a dozen lower ranking soldiers who have had a much harder time.
We should have the dispatch soon, so we'll try and get that this morning too.
One agreed to go on camera, but only if we concealed their identity.
What was it like to come out in the military?
Really rough. First coming out wasn't even the worst of it. It was the secondary months into me starting hormones and me becoming more feminized that really started pissing people off and started making my life even worse because they didn't think that the military should pay for my hormones.
How did people in your unit react?
I mean, it's the military, and it's mostly a lot of right-wing people in the military. And a lot of them were very against it. A lot of them were very like, what the fuck?
Did they say those things to you?
Oh yeah, I heard stuff like that all the time when I first came out. I put called a freak, pervert, that I'm against God, that it's a sin to be who I am. It just makes you feel horrible. When I first started using female bathrooms, they felt the need to walk around the entire unit and tell all the females that a trans woman was going to be using the women's bathroom. I've experienced a lot of retaliation from mostly people I work with closely in my unit. They exclude me. They exclude me from almost everything.
And it wasn't like this before you came out?
No, I used to hang out with these guys all the time. I lost a lot of friends coming out. A lot of my military friends. You know, there could be one day where you deploy with these people and you are dependent on them that you come home. I do not trust most of my unit to protect me. I genuinely believe that some of them would let me get killed if it were to come to it.
Just because you're trans?
Yeah. You'll get one story where someone doesn't fucking face hate, but like the people that are on the lower tier, they will face hate, they will face discrimination, they will face being bullied and hazed and being excluded because of being trans. I wish I would have waited. I wish I would have waited till my time was done, and then I would have been more free to do what I wanted to do with my body and myself and not have it all scrutinized and under control of what the government wants.
My situation at work is much more positive than what most soldiers receive. Most soldiers do receive a lack of support. They have paperwork that has been delayed, lost. They have been called malingerers. If we're going to have a policy and allow transgender soldiers to serve openly, then we need to be able to serve openly. We deserve to be here.
I'm Michael Learmonth, editor-in-chief of Vice News. Too often, traditional news outlets shy away from the real stories and experiences of those living through global conflicts. Not Vice News. Our reporters are on the ground, fearlessly covering the human stories that shape our world. You and millions of others can continue to read, watch, and listen to Vice News for free. But we hope you'll consider making a one-time or ongoing contribution of any size at vice.com/contribute. Every contribution, no matter how big or small, helps support the journalism Vice News brings to you every day. Thank you.